Hello everyone. Now I want to talk a bit about exercise 2, where we're implementing this function evaluation for language lambda s for slow or substitution. And here you can see there's only two cases. So what that means, because we only have two rules, that means you're going to have a branch with only two conditions. But let's go back to the homework 4.racket. And what you'll need to note is that we are implementing this function. We will see something perhaps a bit surprising, which is there's a parameter for subst, okay? Whereas here, there's only one parameter, which is the expression. So the reason we're providing this subst here is because we want to decouple the function that performs variable substitution so that when you upload homework 2, this exercise does not depend on your own implementation of the substitution function. And therefore, even if you don't know how to implement substitute, you can get full marks on s colon eval. So that's why this first parameter here, so if we squint our eyes and we ignore subst for a moment, what you see is that there's a single parameter called exp for expression, because it matches the single parameter here in the notation, as we see before. This is the notation, the mathematical notation, and this is the code notation, right? So they're equivalent. And we covered this in the previous lesson. So now what I want to tell you is, let's look at the test cases. So the test cases, I only have three, and they're written in a style very similar to check subst, right? In the sense that both parameters are quoted terms. So this is a quoted term and this is another quoted term. You're not manipulating the terms directly, right? So if I do s parse ast of this, I would get something like that, right? So this would be the ast that you would expect. But as before, we just write the quoted term, and internally check minus s colon eval is doing the parse for you automatically, okay? Not only that, it's also using your own implementation of subst. So that actually has a big impact, which means that in some cases, let's say you didn't implement subst properly, you just have the templated version. So what that means is that locally, you won't be able to run the tests because the only implementation you have is your own subst, right? So your test cases are going to run against your own subst. But if you upload it to Gradescope, you will be running against the correct implementation of subst, which means you might get more points if you just upload it to Gradescope rather than running everything locally. So take that into consideration if you're unsure that your s colon subst is properly implemented. But let's go back and now let's go through all exercises. And these are all exercises that we've seen before. So these are nothing new. The basic idea is if we have a value, then we should just return a value. So let's look at what kind of values could we have. Well, a value is either in the lambda s language, a value is either a number or a lambda. Okay, so I could also write a test case that says, if I try to evaluate the number 10, I should get the number 10 back because a number is returned by itself. Another example that I have is this one that is saying if you have a lambda, you return the lambda as itself. Why? Because of this rule, right? Where a lambda, a function declaration, is a value, and therefore, if you get a value on the left-hand side as your argument, then you should return the argument itself. So the argument is this lambda x, so we return it itself. So your code should do that. So how do you do that? Well, first you need to check if the thing is a value, and if it's a value, just return whatever exp you got, okay? Next thing we need to do is the second rule. And the second rule is just saying if you have a function application, then you need to do all of these things. And these we already covered in a previous lesson, so I don't want to spend too much time there. But what I want to focus on are the two examples that we see here. So the first example, what we see here, is a very simple example where we have an outer function that takes a parameter y, and in it, inside it returns another function that takes a parameter x. When you pass 1 to the outer function, what you're doing is you're finding and replacing every y, and you're replacing it by 1. So therefore, the body of this function is this. So I need to find and replace y and return it by 1. And that's why the return value is this, right? So a simpler example is perhaps this one, where you have lambda x, and then you pass x. If you pass some number, it should return that number itself. So please note that in this exercise and in all of homework 4, there are no addition, there's no plus, there's no minus, there's nothing. The only thing you have is function application and declaring nested functions. That's the only thing you have, okay? So when you write examples with lambda, nested lambdas and function applications, but do not write pluses there, because that would not be a valid thing. Because plus is not defined, then you will get undefined behavior. Okay, so in our next video, we're going to talk about the language lambda E, which we've been covering in today's lecture.